We've got breaking news out of the NFL where 49ers star Christian McCaffrey has been ruled out for Sunday's game against the Vikings. The all-pro tailback will miss a second straight game with calf and Achilles injuries. Now, with CMC out, Jordan Mason will once again get the start in the backfield for the Niners. Mason ran for a career-high 147 yards and a touchdown in San Francisco's season-opening win against the Jets. Now, when asked about whether putting Christian McCaffrey on the IR is an option, here's what Kyle Shanahan had to say.
It's something we're considering now. Yeah, yesterday was his worst day. It's on and off, but with it, yesterday having the most pain, something we're going to be discussing here in the next 24 hours.
All right, that's tough to hear for fantasy owners that have Christian McCaffrey. Let's talk about it with Heath Cummings. You certainly do not want to hear that's something we're considering, putting him on the IR. Yesterday was his worst day. So we'll talk about it, Heath, long term. And then this week, week two, what do you do? Because obviously we want to think, hey, Jordan Mason, that is the answer. But if you have CMC in your lineup, what do you do for week two in this matchup with the Vikings?
Yeah, we can start with the positive. If you have Jordan Mason, congratulations. You have a must-start running back. He's top 15 in all formats, top 10 in non-PPR and half PPR. Throw a party. If you have Christian McCaffrey, it really depends on what type of league you're playing in and what your record is. If you get to Tuesday in a redraft league and you're 0-2, my suggestion would be go shop Christian McCaffrey to every team that's 2-0. Take the best deal. Otherwise, your season is about over. If you're in a dynasty or a keeper league, then maybe I'm trying to hold on to Christian McCaffrey until he comes back, scores 3 touchdowns in a game, and then sell him for future draft picks. But the fact of the matter is, if you draft a guy at the 101 and he doesn't play the first 2 weeks of the season and he might be going on IR, it is full-blown panic mode unless you were fortunate enough to have him backed up with Jordan Mason, and then Jordan Mason's just going to be like 90% of Christian McCaffrey and everything's still awesome.
Yeah, so the folks that have Jordan Mason, they're just hoping for another performance that they saw from him against the Jets. Let's talk, worst case here, Heath, if he does go on the IR and you do have Christian McCaffrey and that was your number one overall pick, what do you do? How do you approach that situation for the rest of the season? I know we're kind of getting ahead of ourselves, but we have to consider those options based off of what Shanahan just said.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously a lot easier if you have an IR spot in your league. And even if you don't, you have no choice but to hold Christian McCaffrey. I think like the only way that you can legitimately keep him on your roster is if you can stay close to 500 without him. If you can't, you've got to go and try to trade him to a team that started. And I don't think you should trade him thinking you're going to get 90% of the 90 cents on the dollar. I'm not sure you're going to get 80 cents on the dollar. But if you're 0-2 and your best player is not playing, it doesn't really matter. You've got to find a way to make a deal.
All right, Heath, let's talk about maybe some other options on offense there for the 49ers. We were talking a lot about George Kittle props all day today, if he's going to go over his receiving prop. Your thoughts on Kittle and some of those other playmakers there on offense for the 49ers?
I mean, it's a positive for pretty much every one of these guys whenever any of them misses time. So definitely the biggest winner outside of Jordan Mason is going to be Deebo Samuel. We saw him with 8 carries in week 1. He's had an increased role, probably more likely to have some of those running back targets than McCaffrey normally gets because Jordan Mason's not really much of a pass catcher. Deebo Samuel is a top 12 wide receiver. George Kittle is a must start top 6 or 7 tight end. The one who's interesting, the one who we're going to be watching is Brandon Ayuk. He got off to the slow start in week 1. He of course wasn't at practice for most of the fall. And so I do have a little bit of concern with Ayuk. He's still a starter as a wide receiver too, but if he has another dud this week, then we might have to actually consider benching him next week.
You know, it's only week 2 and we already have some big names here that are on the injury report. We're going to go down the list and talk about a handful of these, Heath, but I want to zone in on the Packers right now because we have Jordan Love and Jaden Reed for different injuries. Both are questionable. I want to start with Jordan Love because if it is Malik Willis, how do you feel about, you know, the rest of that offense there? And when I'm seeing Jordan Love get hurt in that game against the Eagles, I'm not thinking like, hey, he's getting better every day. Like in my mind, it's like, all right, I got to go find another quarterback. But how would you approach the situation there with Love?
I mean, obviously you have to find a different quarterback, and that other quarterback should not be Malik Willis. You see his 3 career starts here. He has not thrown for 100 yards in an NFL game yet, and he made 3 starts. He's averaged 78 yards passing per start. And he's not, it's not like he's had this wild success on the ground to make up for it. There's absolutely no chance, even in a 2 quarterback league, that I want to start Malik Willis this week, and he's terrible news for anyone who catches passes on the Green Bay Packers.
And what about Jaden Reed? He's also questionable, dealing with a calf and a shin injury.
I almost hope that he just takes, as somebody who has quite a few Jaden Reed teams, I'd really just rather him take the week off. I want him to be 100% when Jordan Love comes back. I'm not starting Jaden Reed with Malik Willis as his quarterback, even if Jaden Reed is 100%. So I would sit him. I would sit Christian Watson. I would sit Romeo Doubs. I'd sit the tight ends. Start Josh Jacobs, because he ought to have about 400 carries in this game if the Packers play it right. Don't start anybody who's catching passes in this game.
So I actually just made the switch from, I think I put Watson in for Nico Collins, but you think I should flip it back?
I really always try to give you the best, and I try to be nice about it, but that would be a really terrible mistake. Start Nico Collins.
Okay, that was like a little earlier in the week, because Nico Collins didn't really come through with me after week one, but the wheels are turning as we're having these conversations. But that's why we do these segments together, Heath, because you give me expert advice on my fantasy team. Let's talk about the Bears, because their receiver room taking quite a hit when it's coming to the injuries, because we have Keenan Allen and Roma Dunze that are listed as questionable for that matchup against Houston. What's that mean for the rest of the offense? Is it DJ Moore time more so? Are they going to lean to the run game? If you have either of these guys, how do you approach it?
So the thing that nobody really seems to want to talk too much about is that Caleb Williams' passing performance in week one looked a lot like Malik Willis, double digits in terms of passing yards, 6.3 air yards per pass attempt, and still completed fewer than 50% of his passes. It was really bad. That being said, with both Keenan Allen and Roma Dunze banged up, I do like DJ Moore as a number two wide receiver this week. I think you can count on him to be a top 15, top 20 guy. I actually was pretty confident in Keenan Allen earlier in the week when I thought that Allen would play and Odunze would be out. Now it's kind of if all three of these guys play, I'm only starting DJ Moore. If Odunze is out, Keenan Allen's a boom bust flex. I loved the 11 targets last week, but I didn't like the way the connection looked between he and Caleb Williams. And I saw Roma Dunze dropped in one of my leagues. I immediately made a claim for him. You should not drop round one rookie wide receivers after 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Give them a month, because we've seen a bunch of these guys struggle early in the season and then become league winners in the second half. Hold Roma Dunze, go add him if someone's dropping him, but don't start him even if he plays.
Ooh, someone dropped him after week one. That's like prisoner of the moment energy in whatever league that is, Heath. Let's talk about Russ, because we're kind of in the same situation with him for week two, listed as questionable against the Broncos. So it's likely going to be Justin Fields under center there for the Steelers. What's the fantasy impact overall for the Steelers offense if it is Justin Fields like we think it's going to be there for Pittsburgh against the Broncos?
Yeah, it's a really bad matchup for the wide receivers anyway, so I don't love George Pickens in this matchup. I would view him as a boom-bust number three wide receiver. Fields' rushing upside always puts him in the conversation for a fantasy starter. This week, he's closer to a high-end QB2. I think he's QB17 in my rankings. He is the best streamer available. If you've got, you just slept through the waiver wire earlier this week and you have Jordan Love and you have to replace him now, Justin Fields is the guy to go get, but I don't think he's going to be a top 12 quarterback. I just don't think Arthur Smith trusts him all that much. He said in that game against the Falcons, I didn't want him to throw over the middle because I didn't want Jesse Bates to ruin the game. That tells you how Arthur Smith feels about throwing the ball right now.
All right, we have the Seahawks. We're going to talk about them. Ken Walker listed as doubtful. So what does this mean for Charbonnet? I know he was rostered in a bunch of leagues after week one or picked up there, but what does that mean Ken Walker? I was about to say Charbonnet, but Ken Walker listed as doubtful there. What does that mean for that offense in Seattle?
So this is more bad news at the running back position, because Ken Walker was supposed to be a top 15 must start running back this week. I'm just basically replacing him with Zach Charbonnet. Charbonnet hasn't been very efficient as a rusher in the NFL, but he's a very good pass catcher. We saw that with his touchdown reception last week. He's going to see 15 plus carries. Seattle, surprisingly, bottom three in terms of pass rate over expected. They went very run heavy in week one. I think they'll be very run heavy against a bad offense and the Patriots in week two. Don't be surprised if it's something like 18 carries for 55 yards for Charbonnet. But I think he catches the ball enough. I like his touchdown chances enough. I'm starting Zach Charbonnet as long as Ken Walker is out.
All right, so Heath, Charbonnet was on my bench, and DeAndre Swift did not really come through for me in week one. Who would you start? Because my other running back is Breece Hall, so he's going to stay put, obviously. But would you start Charbonnet over DeAndre Swift?
Yeah, I don't think. Yeah, I would actually. I don't.
Hello, xin chào các bạn đã quay trở lại với kênh YouTube của mình. Video ngày hôm nay mình sẽ tiếp tục tạo ra những sản phẩm, những tác phẩm thật là đẹp và tuyệt vời để gửi tặng đến các bạn. Mình mong rằng các bạn xem video của mình thì hãy cho mình xin những lượt like và lượt đăng ký kênh để ủng hộ mình, để mình tiếp tục lấy động lực ra video. Mình cảm ơn các bạn rất là nhiều. Mình không biết nói gì hơn. Mình cảm ơn các bạn rất là nhiều.
Cảm ơn các bạn ơi. Mình lại nghe tay này à? Tay nghe thì nói, tay nghe này à?
Ừ.
iPhone khiếp quá. Như vậy là mình đã mở xong rồi nha các bạn ơi.
Hello, xin chào các bạn đã quay trở lại với kênh YouTube của mình. Video ngày hôm nay mình sẽ tiếp tục tạo ra những sản phẩm, những tác phẩm thật là đẹp và tuyệt vời để gửi tặng đến các bạn. Mình mong rằng các bạn xem video của mình thì hãy cho mình xin những lượt like và lượt đăng ký kênh để ủng hộ mình, để mình tiếp tục lấy động lực ra video. Mình cảm ơn các bạn rất là nhiều. Mình không biết nói gì hơn. Mình cảm ơn các bạn rất là nhiều.
Bây giờ mình đi cơm mỏ rồi các bạn. Như vậy là mình đã tốt xong rồi.